like to invite our best man, John Wass. Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah! Hello.
Good evening, everybody. My name is John, and I have the honor of being Richard's best man. I don't want to take up too much time, so, but if I have to, I will. Just kidding, it's gonna be quick. Alright. When I first met Richard 11 years ago, I was pretty sure that he didn't like me very much. I remember not making a great first impression with my poorly executed Family Guy quotes. And after a day or so, the ice broke, and I came to realize that he didn't like me for a bunch of other reasons. Other than that, just kidding. But seriously though, once Richard and I got a chance to sit back and get to know each other, we quickly became like family. And then we eventually found out what we were actually were kind of family, because your grandpa, my grandpa was your grandpa's godfather.
Yes.
Way back when, we just found that out. Philippines, man. Some of my fondest memories are sleeping over at Richard's house and having Tito Wilma and Tito Rick pick us up some chicken bakes from Costco. That's the champions. I remember group trips to Little Tokyo and Las Vegas and Tito and Tita's crazy awesome band. You can freaking sing karaoke in it. It doesn't get more Filipino than that. Richard was the first in our little friend group to get a car and drive on his own. And that was a huge deal to us back in the day. What? We can go to the beach with no grown-ups? That's awesome. So we would go, Richard would pick us up, and the thing was is that he lived 60 miles away from any of us. But he would still come by, pick us up, bring us where we need to go, bring us back, go home. He did that for a year. Before he got tired of it. This man's patience knows no bounds. And I really, really respect that. That's like one of the most awesome things I admire about you. Things like marriage seemed so far away back then. None of us ever really thought about it, which is normal for guys, I guess. But here we are today, and it's finally happening. You two have been with each other for years and have stood together for the test of time. And I'm so excited for what's next for the both of you. I think you're going to Japan. That's so cool! Alright, made that joke. In all seriousness, I 100% believe that Richard and Brenda were made for each other. They make their relationship seem completely effortless. Love is an instinct for them, no frills, it just comes naturally. You can see how easy it is for them to love one another. Super chill. They are a perfect pair, they complete one another. Richard's always sleepy and Brenda has insomnia, so that's great. Plus, they have both awesome tastes in horror movies. Richard and Brenda married their best friend, and that's the foundation for a beautiful, fruitful marriage. In this dice roll we call life, you easily rolled a nat 20. So let's all raise a glass to the newlyweds. I don't have one, I just realized.
Yeah.
May your campaign continue to be filled with adventure and happiness. Cheers.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now, some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. years go by. A friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.